Good day, friends. I bid you welcome to your cathedral, St. Stephen's in Harrisburg. I invite you to stand as you are able. We begin within your bulletin. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Together, Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known. And from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray together. God of wisdom and love, in whom we find our joy, help us to listen for your word and to discern your way forward for our church. Give us the insight to hold on to what is true, the courage to explore new ideas, and the boldness to create with you. Let us be shaped by faith for your mission. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Almighty God, you have knit together your elect in one communion and fellowship in the mystical body of your Son, Christ our Lord. Give us grace so to follow your blessed saints in all virtuous and godly living, that we may come to those ineffable joys that you have prepared for those who truly love you, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, in glory everlasting. Amen.
Amen.
I invite you to be seated for the reading of Scripture.
A reading from the first letter of John. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called the children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now, but what we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him. For we will see him as he is, and all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will glory.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." The Gospel of the Lord.
In the name of God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please do be seated, friends. So we're celebrating the Feast of All Hallows, or All Saints. Where did you see the saints of God this week? Where did you perceive virtuous and godly living? Some days you have to look really hard, and some days it's right in front of you. It's feeling to me a little strange celebrating the Feast of All Saints in the context of a pandemic and also during a bitterly contentious election season. Our entire experience this autumn has really evoked more of the aura of Halloween than of All Hallows. We've had cobwebs, not halos. We've had poltergeists and not seraphim. And precious few miracles, have you noticed? And yet, when Jesus preaches his Sermon on the Mount and articulates the Beatitudes that we've heard today, he's really not talking about the sanctity and perfection of some distant heaven. Jesus is not talking about the ideal way that God works in the world. He's announcing that the reign of God has broken into the world in which we live, the actual world, with its concomitant brokenness and calamity. And as Jesus preaches to this crowd, he highlights the sanctity of people who are considered, well, unfortunate at best. Those who've lost and are dispirited, those who are grieving, those who seek righteousness and perhaps know they've missed the mark, those who are merciful or pure of heart or peacemakers, we all know how those people are treated in the world, right? Those who've been persecuted and defamed. These are not the champions of the world. They are the outcast. And through them, as Jesus highlights them, he invites us to reconsider what holiness looks like and the ways in which we perceive that our real relationship is with the working of the Almighty. So in the collect, and I'm sorry you have the wrong collect printed in your bulletin because your priest is the worst proofreader in the entire Western Hemisphere, but in the collect that you're supposed to say for All Saints Day, which I read, we prayed that God would give us grace so to follow the blessed saints in all their virtuous and godly living. How's that working for you? Yeah, for me too. I think we can honestly ask ourselves whether this is a prayer that we will attain soon the bottom line of a shiny sort of holiness, or perhaps more faithfully, it's a prayer that we may be inclined to pursue the gritty process that leads us there into a holy life. In an age of nearly instant everything, we may recognize that we're not quite there yet and that it's not easy to get there. Most of us, especially those who still show up at church, that would be you and whoever joins us virtually, most of us can recognize our own growing edges and our failings. And possibly we could conclude that sainthood is not for us. This following Jesus is not an easy thing. But before giving up, we can also recognize that we can commit to pursuing the process of sanctity, taking one step at a time up the path, led by Christ, nourished by grace. So I'm a bottom line person myself. I'm not patient with process. And yet, process is all we have, especially right now. We tend to look at the stained glass windows, and maybe at our grandmothers, as examples of sainthood. Their pristine example may not feel attainable in our current context. And we've heard that we should seek the perfection of heaven, but you know, as we cast our eyes upward, looking to heaven all the time, we miss the beauty and the holiness that are possible all around us in our imperfect world. The saints did not, do not dwell in heavenly perfection. They dwell in the holy imperfection of earth, in the ordinary light of kitchens and offices, caring for children and the elderly, making sure their neighbors get their medication from the CVS, checking in with their friends on the telephone when they feel it's too dangerous to go out. Those are the saints. And there are also other saints that we may not rub elbows with all the time, who dwell under bridges and in parks, people who struggle to believe and to do the right thing. It is not their perfection that identifies them as saintly. It's their longing for relationship with God and their reliance on the power of God in their very complicated lives. Those who are saints trust in the teaching of the epistle that we just read this morning, this afternoon, oops. We are children of God. And what we do know is this: when Christ is revealed, we will be like him. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves. It's an ongoing process. So saints are human, fully human, and no human being is born fully developed. Saints allow the difficult experiences of their lives to lead them into an intimacy with the Holy One. We are not invited to pursue instant perfection because God knows us better than that. We are invited to live into the holiness of personal and earthly transformation. No matter what develops over the next weeks and months, whether the pandemic runs wild or is controlled, whether the weather is mild or terrible, whether the election process is smooth or difficult, no matter how our lives are going, our identity and our vocation remain the same. We are the children of God. We are invited to live into our holy identity one blessed way at a time. We have abundant work to do in the world, helping God to complete the transformation into the beautiful and holy place worthy of what Jesus called the kingdom. Do not let your souls be troubled. Do not allow yourselves to dwell in fear. Cling to faith in God. Cling to faith in Christ. And be the saints the world needs, one step, one day at a time. And may it be so. And now for something completely different. I invite you to stand and renew your baptismal promises. The words are found within your bulletin. Do you reaffirm your renunciation of evil and renew your commitment to Jesus Christ?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will, with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
May Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed upon us the forgiveness of sins, keep us in eternal life by his grace, in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen. Please join me in the responsive prayers of the people. Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church, that we all may be one. Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you, that your name may be glorified by all people. We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons, that they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments. We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world, that there may be justice and peace on the earth. We pray for the Church of the Province of West Africa, the Most Reverend Dr. Jonathan Baobao Bonaparte Hart, Primate and Metropolitan, Church of the Province of West Africa, Archbishop of the Internal Province of West Africa, and Bishop of Liberia, and St. Paul's in Lock Haven. We pray for our parish families, John and Donna Havens, Christina Sell and her children, Parker, Graham, and Layla, Kyle Peters, Chloe Austrich, Kelsey Reyes, Emily Farwell, and Holly Fursch. Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake, that our works may find favor in your sight. We pray for the first grade class of St. Stephen's Episcopal School and their teacher, Lisa Martin. We remember together those who have asked for our prayers: Joyce, Lenore, Nora, Richard, Barbara, Casey, Jerry, Jim, Rick, Lily, Pat, Michaela, Cole, Connie, Andrew, Kathy Ann, Larry, Paul, June, David, Don, Jennifer, Linda, Aminata, Courtney, Karen, Gareth, Sean, Macala, Matt, Bennett, Martha, Kathy, Allison, Lenny, Liam, Chuck, Chris, Melissa, Jordan, John, David, Margaret, Mike, Jan, Sarah, Helen, Linda, Janice, Judith, Bracia, Nancy, Marilyn, Joan, Robin, Joan, Bob, Sandy, Alan, Emily, John, Ishmael, Margie, and Bernice. Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble, that they may be delivered from their distress. We give thanksgiving for the communion elements in honor of Robert M. Macklemore III by Burke and Barbara Macklemore, and in loving memory of Vernon E. Chandler Jr. by Elaine, Tony, Nicola, and Anthony Salamone. The flowers are given in honor of Ann Yellett's family, past and present. Remembering the saints who have died in this last year: Sandra Loy Stroll, Burnell Guntree, Barry A. Drew, Elaine Alice Dyke Miller, Jerome David Seville, Elizabeth Ann S. Gingrich, Beverly Jean Fortino, Janet Blake Papinski. Give to the departed eternal rest. Let light perpetual shine upon them. We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy. May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom. Let us pray for our own needs and those of others.
I ask your prayers for Kristen and Anthony, both in hospital. O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people, In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. My dear friends, the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
I invite you to share the peace with one another by a holy bow or a friendly wave. If you dwell together, you can exchange a hug. It's a limited group. So, my dears, all the announcements you need to know are in your bulletin. You can take the bulletins home. It's okay. It's only you who've touched them. And of course me, but you know, I'm not that germy. And now for your delight, we present to you Stewardship the Musical. Walk in love, friends, as Christ loved us and gave himself for us.
Like we're finished for the night.
Whose turn is it to put the sheet music away?
Wouldn't it be nice if we had a budget for the new music?
Oh, well, forget about that sheet music and worry about that organ getting it fixed.
Music makes the church go round, the church go round, the church go round. Music makes the church go round, it makes the church go round. A song, an air, a hymn or a round, a hymn or a round, a hymn or a round is all that makes the church go round. We cannot fool around, the organ leads that sound. Music, 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 music. If you're singing in a church that is rich and they want better music, they can pay for an organ rehab. If you're singing in a church without cash and they need a new organ, you can't just go and put it on your tab. We have music in our church and we find we are sad to consider that our organ may wheeze quite a lot. We can take it on the chin, make a pledge, and begin to deliver on an organ that sounds as it up. Music makes the church go around, the church go around, the church go around. Music makes the church go around, that sparkling singing sound. It makes the church go round. Music, 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 music. Church go around, the church go around. Music makes the church go around, the sparkling singing sound that makes the church go round.
We must be getting worse, they're not clapping. I invite you to stand as you are able for the great thanksgiving which is within your bulletin. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on the first day of the week overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Thank you.
give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your words spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where, with Saint Stephen and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
These are the gifts of God for you, the people of God, holy gifts for holy people.
Take away the sins of the world.
for those who are unable to be with us today but are with us virtually, a prayer of spiritual communion. In union, O Lord, with your faithful people at every altar of your church, where Holy Eucharist is now being celebrated, I desire to offer you praise and thanksgiving. I remember your death, Lord Christ. I proclaim your resurrection. I await your coming in glory. And since I cannot receive you today in the sacrament of your body and blood, I beseech you to come spiritually into my heart. Cleanse and strengthen me with your grace, Lord Jesus, and let me never be separated from you. May I live in you and you in me, in this life and in the life to come. Amen.
The prayer after communion is found within your bulletin. I invite you to stand as you are able. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you, as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of God's Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior. The blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen.
us spend this week looking for signs that the kingdom of heaven is breaking into our lives and greeting those complicated saints that we meet along the way. And now let us go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Spirit.
Thanks be to God.